So I just drove for Uber Eats and I mixed it up really in a big way here. Starting my shift in the early AM, starting at 7 a.m. So I want to show you these orders, of course, my earnings here, because I feel like there were some takeaways, specifically for an early AM shift, and I need your help to determine if I actually made some good money. Welcome to the channel. My name is Mike. On this channel, I help you with the gig economy, your side hustle, your full-time hustle, making money and generating multiple revenue streams. So if you are new here, consider subscribing. So for some context, I'm coming to you from the very cold Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and normally I drive, let's say, in the afternoon or those dinner rush shifts. But this time I hit the road after an even earlier gym session and went online with Uber Eats. So let's find out how much I made. So first order from Starbucks, make note of that. $7.24 for 2 miles. So regardless of what app you're driving for, obviously you want to make the most money. So being in those dense areas, right? Looking at the dollars to mile ratio, how much am I getting paid for the miles driven is the foundation of your driving. Now, specifically on Uber Eats, what you want to do here on the app, if you can, is what I'm going to call a bonus stacking. So simply do just that. Stack your bonuses, the incentive pay, specifically again on Uber Eats because other apps like DoorDash doesn't have this. So if we see the surge pay, which is the really dollars in addition to your standard payouts, and then the boost pay, which is not a flat dollar, that is a multiplier. If you can combine those during busy times and in different segments of your marketplace, that's ideal on Uber Eats. Now, kind of surprisingly, this one was busy enough during this, again, 7 a.m. start to my shift here to give me some surge pay. So surge, the flat dollar bonus here, this one, $1 extra in surge pay. Now, here's one tip, especially if you're newer to Uber Eats. I got this screen as far as the payout here. You can see $3.50. Well, that's not what we were quoted on the order request screen. Well, don't worry. Typically on Uber Eats, and Postmates is kind of the same way here, you will see, or at least hopefully will see, those tips roll in a little bit later in your day. Order number two, right back to another Starbucks, $6.77, this time 2.7 miles. So now let's tie in this order from the first order. Now this one, it's at 7:31 a.m. So think about this for your morning blitz shifts here in those early a.m. hours here. Think about what's actually open. It's gonna be the breakfast spots, right? And really just the breakfast spots. That trend continues. So really pay attention to this. This one, it's 8 a.m. It's our next order here. So if you are gonna take those early morning shifts, anticipate maybe wait by those breakfast spots. This one for Dunkin', $8.80, 4.7 miles. So the next order that I'm gonna show you here, it's another Starbucks order, but I want you to comment and let me know if you've seen this. I've mentioned this before, but this is something specifically for Uber Eats. It's the blackout screen. The blackout screen, as you can see, it's just that. This one, $6.77. And we've seen this, again, is it a glitch or is it kind of a punishment to you as a driver? Maybe you've ignored two or three consecutive orders and then Uber Eats gives you this, really masking some detail. Let me know down below. Okay, not a breakfast spot, but again, somewhere that's actually open in the morning here. This one for Sunoco, which I was kind of surprised to get here, $7.36, just 2 miles. That's a strong dollars to mile ratio. I just wanted to show you this screen here. So this is what your app's gonna look like when there is that surge pay. So your marketplace is gonna have the yellows, the oranges, even the reds when it gets really busy. And then the darker the color, the higher that surge or bonus pay. Now, it's not really guaranteed, but as long as you're in one of those colored zones, you should get that bonus pay. Now, I only say not guaranteed because maybe if you're on the fringe there, you really have to look at where that pickup is. And then remember, I told you that tips can roll in a little bit later. Well, here we go. Here's one of our first tips, $3.22 tip coming in here. And a quick timeout here on the shift. I want you to look in your promotions tab and let me know if you have this. These are the consecutive trip bonuses, or I'll just call it a streak bonus. So for this Saturday, if I accept three trips in a row, now it does have to be consecutive trips here, between 2 a.m. and 3 a.m., I just have to start one trip sequence in that time period, I'll get an extra $18 in addition to the tips, in addition to any surge if that's present, in addition to any boost that's present. Now, obviously, they're not all at 2 a.m. or 3 a.m., so don't worry there. So again, a pretty quick, what I'm calling a morning blitz here on Uber Eats. And before we get in the numbers, let me know, is it better to drive in the morning, the afternoon, or the evening? So this morning's shift was from 7 a.m. until 9:15 a.m. again here in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. During this time, my gross revenue, $43.72, equals just under $20 an hour, $19.43 per hour. During this time, I completed 6 deliveries. As you can see here, I did receive 6 tips as well, with an average tip on a par, $4.02 on average. Business miles, 18.1, that's a very strong payout per mile, $2.42 per mile. And for that driving, I get a tax deduction of $10.14. So driving in the morning, I feel like it can be good, especially if you have enough of those breakfast spots, because maybe not at 7 a.m., but 8 a.m., 9 a.m., you're gonna get that work commute or some of that work commute that are placing a lot of those breakfast orders. I feel like if you can combine the demand from that, especially the work commute there, the breakfast orders, if you have enough of those spots there, and then demand in your marketplace, any surge pay, hopefully, or any boost pay with that really morning commute rush, and then also multi-app, driving on different apps at the same time, just simply picking the best one for you, there could be some good money here in this morning blitz. But again, let me know, because that will vary based on your marketplace. Again, do you have enough of those breakfast spots? Does Uber Eats have any streak bonuses or any boost pay during those AM hours? Let us know down below. So if you got value in this video, definitely drop me a like. And you can also click or tap the screen here for my most recent video, as well as a video recommended for you. And I'll see you in the next one.